Hi and welcome to Cosplayers React. I'm Rascal Rabbit Cosplay and I play Adrien in Cat Noir.
And I'm Luminara and I play Marinette and Ladybug.
And I'm Hilda Glitz and I still play Chloe. They swapped seats and it's all gone mad.
Today we're going to be reacting to Puppeteer 2, which was heavily requested.
As always, this will include spoilers for all of Miraculous, so go and watch that and then come back to this if you don't want to get spoiled.
At the time of recording this, Ladybug has just come out, so we don't know anything about the episodes that follow that one.
Shall we get into
Let's
it?
Let's do it!
Let's go. Do it!
Right, we have to address this. This like slight silent movie ragtime that he's playing.
Honky tonk.
I thoroughly enjoy it. I also love that he's just sort of like looking at Plag, just like...
It's really cute.
He's just smiling and having a good time playing the piano and I'm just...
Do you think Adrien's that kid that turns up at parties and has like one song he knows how to play?
That's
and
me.
It's this honky tonk piano thing.
That's everyone... me, and I'm not ashamed to say that it's Bella's lullaby from Twilight.
What's up, bro?
You know, I've got to go back to the Griffin Wax Museum. Do you want to come with me this time?
Sure thing, dude. I'll be right there. Actually,
he seemed a little bit too eager to leave.
He's on a date with Ali, and Ali's like, Excuse me. Your best bro phones you up and suddenly you're out of here? We're having a dance day.
This is the sort of the boy logic in Miraculous though.
It's the pact.
It is the pact.
The brotherhood. The Miraculous brotherhood.
I bring two friends. Hey, wait.
You're already pushing your luck with like two friends. Do not involve Marinette in this.
I think Natalie thought he had more than one.
Jesus!
You're not wrong.
Ouch.
Adrien invited us.
There's no saying no. We're coming to get you.
Doesn't Nino still have Adrien on call on the other phone?
Nino's expression here is just killing me. He's sort of like,
I've never seen such strong turtle energy.
You could stare at the statues together. Marinette loves to... She loves statues, which is perfect since the Wax Museum is full of them.
That was a shambles of a social interaction.
Usually, like, it's Marinette who's, like, just painful to watch. Like, with affection, she is painful to watch in moments. Or sometimes Adrien, a little bit less, but that was bad.
Chloe's never painful to watch.
Marinette, what about my superhero costume?
No one cares, Manon.
It's your favourite character. As we know, Luminara has some very strong opinions about Manon.
Nothing, it's got nothing to do with us leaving you and Adrien alone. To look at the statues as just friends, of course.
Don't worry, Manon. It's just that all.
What is wrong with Nino this episode?
Nino's got a bad case of the Marinette.
He's got.
No! Stop it.
I really enjoy how oblivious Adrien is to this entire discussion. Because, Adrien. As you will notice from this episode, Adrien is it. He's so foolish.
He's just very oblivious
he's
to
a
everything.
Pretty face, but there's nothing.
Someone just
much
needs to
going
sit him down and just.
Oh, yeah, Nino are boyfriend and girlfriend, and they probably want to spend some time alone together without us.
Really? Why did you invite them then? If you're there, like, I've got some friends who are very coupley, and I'm aware that they want to spend time together, then why are you inviting them out in a group hang if they just want to go out with each other?
In fairness, Nino did invite Alia himself, which
That's
is a bit
true.
Like.
Joined at the hip.
It's like, Nino, do you want to come to this wax museum? And he's like, well, you know, it'll be even more fun. Third wheeling you.
Let me bring my GF.
I mean, like, thank goodness Marinette came along, because otherwise it'd just be
Let's bring the person we're desperately trying to make your GF.
He would just make the whole thing awkward.
He
would feel even more alone than he would have done if he just went by himself.
You and Marinette were boyfriend and girlfriend. She has lots of photos of you all over her bedroom.
That's because she loves fashion and I'm a fashion model.
But then why are there so many...
What? How does he come to that conclusion without missing a beat? He's like... Yeah, obviously she's got pictures of me all over her wall because she's into fashion.
Doesn't he no really know that she has these images?
I think he does.
He clearly does. Adrien, don't you have pictures of Ladybug all over your room?
That's just because he's into Ladybug. Oh, wait.
That's
how it works.
He just really loves superheroes.
You told me you wouldn't tell Nino.
I haven't told him. Right, Nino? I didn't tell you anything.
She didn't tell me, and besides, I...
Damn, this disloyalty. Man, you tell your friend not to tell.
The friendship pact, you just don't tell. It's like,
You don't tell someone and then be like, oh, like, don't tell anyone else. Like, no, that's you've already done the damage.
I told her I won't tell.
So you didn't tell anyone what Alia didn't tell you, or did you? What are you guys talking about? Nothing.
Good job Adrien wasn't in the car.
Hi, Veronique.
Thanks for coming on such short notice, Adrien. I'm sorry, but a piece of your statue went missing yet again. Just goes to show how popular you are.
What? She's like, a bit of your statue's gone missing. One of your weird fans just stole your arm.
And then the camera immediately pans to Marinette.
All right, we're gonna unpack that later.
To go in, even though it's closed, it's like we're princesses. Hey, did you hear me?
Be careful this time, right?
Hold up, hang on. Is that Sabrina's mum?
Wait, no, I swear that's the woman. I mean, it might be Sabrina's mum because they all sort of pop up in other places, don't they? But the woman in, the mine episode who was running the play.
I think it's her. Maybe is Sabrina's mum, though.
Probably.
Oh, no, because Sabrina's dad is the mine.
It's just dead spit of Sabrina.
It is a bit.
Yeah.
Mr. Jagged, can you give me an autograph, please? Why isn't anyone paying attention to me today?
Because you're the worst.
Does she not know that they're in a waxwork museum? Was she not briefed?
Listen up, Manon. This is the deal. We're going to a waxwork museum. Nobody here is real. They won't speak to you, no matter how hard you try.
Some alone time together, yeah?
So no matter what Adrien asks you, just deny.
Not at all. That's not why we came here at all. Oh.
Nino!
Nino! Why are the boys so stupid?
At all either.
Really? So why did you want to come here then? Did it have something to do with Marinette?
No. You've got it all wrong, dude. No.
Adrien is impossible to offend because you could tell him anything and he'll believe it.
Nina's basically sitting there being like he almost. If I was Adrien and I was cluing into the fact that Nino is obviously lying to me, because in this it doesn't feel like Adrien has clocked that Nino's lying to
him. Oh, he absolutely hasn't.
So I would be going, well, I feel like you're working up to telling me that you only came here because you wanted a free VIP tour of the Waxwork Museum, which I would be really upset by. You know, if I was sort of had a celebrity status amongst my friends, and then my friends used me for like free tickets and like cool events and or like, you know, free stuff, I'd be really upset. But that isn't where Adrien thinks this is going. And I'm like, where do you think it's going? Nino's just being very, very shifty.
He's got so much trust in his friend. It's just...
Not with Marinette or with you, and even less with you and Marinette alone by yourselves.
I'm confused. Marinette wants to be alone with me?
Adrien's confused. Wow.
Breaking news.
Destroyed.
Marinette alone with you? No way, dude. You couldn't be further from the truth. It's the exact opposite, actually.
Marinette doesn't want to be with me.
This whole interaction.
The whole interaction is just like at every turn, it just gets like more and more wrong and far away from what the reality of the situation is. How not to interact? A story by Adrien and Nino.
This episode
a play in three acts.
Look at him, he's like proper heartbroken because now he thinks that Marinette doesn't like him.
I mean, the thing is though, like what reason does he have to think that she does like him? Every single time she interacts with him, she won't make eye contact. She like freaks out and runs away. She's like,
in fairness,
I would start to think that she didn't like me if that's how she was interacting.
Yeah, no, you're right actually. You got a point there.
Manon, come here.
Does she hate me?
No, dude, she likes you a lot. Barely.
What's so wrong with just saying, hey, dude, Marinette kind of likes you. Like, how'd you feel about that?
He'd get in trouble with his girlfriend though, wouldn't he?
Well, he's already in trouble with his girlfriend. He's already messed up.
So instead of saying that, now he's just said, yeah, she barely likes you.
No, but
which I think is worse.
She can't stand you.
I'd really bummed if I knew Marinette didn't like me.
I forgot about this weird little way that this episode is structured. We now rewind to get
Marinette and Alia's conversation.
I kind of like cute. It, yeah.
It's fun.
Adds another dimension.
No, not like that. I am so not ready. I'd have to practice first and wash my hair, and I'm not even wearing my lucky socks. It's up to you, girl, but I'm just
She's not even wearing her lucky socks. That's so cute.
What do her lucky socks
have
look like?
Have we ever seen her wear socks?
No!
Really? If we see an episode where they're wearing socks, we know what's going to go down.
I've got a theory. Unless her lucky sock is her ladybug suit.
That's fair. That's, yeah.
Because technically the whole thing is a sock.
Yeah,
the whole thing is a sock.
And it is lucky.
Manon, come here! Look, Marinette, my mommy's a famous person too! Yeah, right, okay.
Don't be bemused, it's just the news!
I wish I still had my hairbrush then.
And it's that blooming weather girl that isn't Aurora Borealis.
The last Borealis.
Oh my god, oh my god. It's Chloe's mum. Look.
Oh boy.
It's Chloe's mum and dad. Why isn't Chloe there?
Why is the mayor doing jazz hands behind his back?
He's a jazzy man.
This is where we store our wax. It comes straight from our very own beehives up on the roof of the museum.
So I heard we have to do your hand again, right, Veronica? Mm-hmm.
The beard's really well done.
Bring me the head of Thomas Astruc.
Like it.
Little cameo from Thomas Astruc, the writer of Ladybug here. Just his head.
Just his head.
Genuine yak hair.
He knows.
So like he is being
passed. If he said it's genuine human hair, because that. Otherwise, it's implying that Thomas Astruc's hair is yak hair because it's really accurate.
Yak hair.
That was a good one. Well done.
Oh, I didn't know Nina was a famous person too.
She did serve that.
How is she not a lot more alarmed by that? That would have absolutely given me a heart attack as a child.
Because she doesn't have a heart.
Damn.
You take good care of Adrien. He must not get bored a single second. What? But I... No! Don't leave me alone with him!
She fully ran across the room that Adrien is in, yelling, "Don't leave me alone with him!" Like, Marinette, you twit.
That's called for.
Goodness me.
I like you. Well, like, but not like that. What I mean is, you're not exactly a good friend, you know?
That was a whole mess. That was a whole mess. She was this close to just being able to, like, really gently just be like, hey, look, I do like you. I like you a lot. Just putting that out there.
Just
you take that
there.
How you will. Whereas instead
but
she goes,
no.
Oh, you're not exactly a good friend. I feel true. Like Marinette going, yes, I do like you. He probably would have just taken that as, ah, I like you too, Marinette, as a friend.
But then, if I'm not a good friend, what am I to you?
You're...
This is really sad.
Someone just give Adrien a hug here. Like, honestly, like, someone just needs to not lie to him.
You're...
You're
toilets!
You're a toilet! Great. Well done, Marinette. It really gets me, because I'm like, okay, listen, it is very, very, like, nerve-wracking when suddenly you are having to have, like, a conversation that you've been not expecting to have with somebody you really like, and, you know, maybe you must mess it up. But they're there together. How is she managing to make this worse by acting like she's totally disinterested / like actually
it's
really
her
rude
power.
To him. I'm just like, just all you could have done is, yeah, I do really like you.
All right, here's something I want to throw out there. Has anyone spoken to Adrien completely genuinely? Not just this episode,
no.
But in general.
No. Because, right, and it is a little bit sad because
Nino
most of the time does speak to Adrien like he's a proper person. However, when Nino is with Alia, because Alia is only about wingmanning Marinette and Adrien, Nino turns into sort of like wingman number two, and so then is incapable of interacting with Adrien properly because all he's trying to do is impress Alia by getting them together. Marinette is incapable of talking to him. Chloe just sees him as an accessory. And everyone else, I don't know, he just doesn't really interact with anyone else.
Thanks, I'm sad.
Yeah, same.
Plag does.
Yeah, Plag.
Yeah,
no, Plag sees him as a cheese machine.
Get me some cheese.
Plag tells it like it is.
He does.
Plag is his only friend.
Press F to pay respects.
I'm sure I did something to mess up our friendship by accident. I'm so clueless about these things.
You're not wrong. You're not
wrong.
That's
the first thing he said today that's intelligent.
But the thing is, I just, it's so sad because it's like everyone around him is acting really weird.
Yeah, and he just doesn't know what's going on.
And he has no clue. And honestly, to be honest, like, I wouldn't know what was going on. If all my friends started acting like that, I'd also be like,
it's like, yeah, we know what's happening, but this boy does not.
So I really like that they do actually address the fact that their Akuma forms are kind of a traumatizing time. Like, you know, you're down and out and you've been taken advantage of in a way that you've caused a lot of damage and upset to everyone. And yes, obviously Ladybug did undo it, but you know, to have, like for Alia, to see her villain self in a museum as an exhibit for what? The ongoing terrorism of Paris? Like, this is a bit grim. Like, they're not heroes.
Especially for Alia as well, because like, she's always been such a big superhero fan and she's very about doing the right thing.
It's weird to see ourselves like that, as supervillains.
It's because you don't look at them properly. These aren't supervillains. These are all the people Ladybug and Cat Noir have saved.
Good way of putting it, Nino. So this is the thing, when Nino's not trying to match make, he's got some good things to say. We do love Nino. I really like Nino.
Occasionally.
Why doesn't anyone want to play with me?
I don't know. Maybe because you're really annoying.
I'm getting him on my side, you see. It's working on
our friends. Oof. Oh, starting along. And this is why people are stealing Adrien's hand, because people can just walk up, take a
Where's
bit of
the security?
Do you think people have misunderstood what this waxwork museum is and they're like, it's a gift shop where you don't have to pay?
And prey on her despair!
I don't know if I'd describe this as despair. I mean, he's scraping the bottom of the barrel here.
This is really
it's a slow day.
A child. However, I mean, she's just been left alone in a museum for a bit and just been a bit ignored. Like, I feel like if I was like 6 or 7, I'd sort of get over that in about a minute.
Making her laugh, doing pranks like you always do for me.
Super cool. I'm super cool.
Watch this, Plag. What exactly?
This scene.
Here we go, lads. This is the scene.
This is quite the scene.
Exactly how you doing? Shh, I can't let her think it's the real me.
I'm super cool. I'm super cool. I'm super cool. I'm super cool. I'm super... Ah!
I think this makes a lot more sense in the dub than it did in the French version. I think the fan sub was a bit like...
Yes, because when I first watched this,
I was like, why is this happening?
The English dub was not out, and so we watched both. You and I watched, I don't know about you.
Did you watch
it? I know, I watched it in English.
We watched it in French and the subtitles were quite hastily done. This is definitely a lot different from the French version.
It wasn't like very obvious, maybe in the French or in the sub, that it was like a joke that he was playing on Marinette. It just, we were just sort of watching, we were like, but why is he doing that? Like, why would...
He's playing a fun prank. Hi guys, welcome to my prank channel. It's me, Adrien Agresse.
Prank patrol.
I miss prank patrol.
I also miss prank patrol.
Oh, wow, it looks so real. The wax is nearly as hot as skin.
Surely, I just feel like you get to a point where you get that close and you go,
I feel like,
yeah, that's a human being.
I feel like, you know, if you were to, like, actually
Wow, like, it's so lifelike. Yeah, it's that, like a bit like...
Yeah, hang on a minute. Let me just... If you do that, the skin moves.
Like, it has all the pores and natural oils of a human being.
It just starts going, is it... Huh?
Yeah, you'd move! You'd move! He absolutely would have moved if you did this.
It's the way his eye twitches, like... I feel like, actually, if I was in that situation and then Marinette started doing this, I'd probably just stay still and just hope she just leaves the building and I'd leave at closing. I'd be like, it's too awkward now.
You just resign yourself to the life of the statue.
Yeah, I think this is the problem with this scene, is that Marinette is acting totally inappropriate for acting around another human being. However, you know, if that really was a waxwork, what's the harm?
Yeah.
There's nobody around. And then on the flip side, Adrien is obviously now witness to this bizarre behavior. However, he was pretending to be a waxwork. So there's a lot to unpack here. I think it's very, they're both very awkward and it's very endearing, but it does lead to some
awful scenes.
Some very uncomfortable to watch situations.
Question. Why haven't we been molded together in the past? We're destined.
God.
I hate that.
Marble to marble, wax lips against wax lips, and
every time I think I can go back into it,
stop!
I sort of like pause and just like...
I'm like physically cringing, fellas.
Stop!
It's so uncomfortable.
Mind for eternity.
No, 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 no. That's...
Abort.
Marinette, stop! Can she not, like, as she's getting that close, can she not feel him breathing on her? Like...
When she got to the point where it was like, it even smells like the real thing. I didn't want to tell you, babe, waxworks don't come with scents.
like, excuse me, Adrien, can we just bottle some of that toilette d'Adrien?
I mean, he does have...
They probably sell that, actually.
Eternity sounds like a long time.
She actually kissed him there. Like, she actually was like, mwah, and that's why he jumped away. Because, oh, it's just so much. It's so much. Like, how mortified would you be if you were Marinette and you'd been like smacking on what you thought was a waxwork? And then Adrien is real. It's
just a lot. It's too much.
I'm so sorry. I didn't mean to scare you. It was just a prank, that's
not
all.
Not funny.
It was just a prank, bro.
It's
just a prank.
You've just been pranked.
What's up, prank?
I see. Me, even after all these months with you guys, I guess I'm still not used to being a good friend.
Yeah, because obviously Adrien is the one at fault here. Well,
but
yeah,
kind of.
There's a lot to unpack.
To be fair, I think he thought it was going to be quite a funny prank. He saw Nino doing it with Manon and he was like, oh, that's quite cute. He didn't anticipate Marinette doing that.
Playing the pranks? I knew you were playing a prank on me, so I just wanted to get you back. Gotcha!
So you didn't really mean all those things you just said?
Of course not.
Haha, you thought I liked you. Pranked! I actually despise you. Got him.
Double prank.
Double prank.
Adrien will literally believe anything.
Can somebody throw me into a vat of wax right now, please?
Hello.
Zero to 100 real fast, and Hawk Moth just turns up.
Well, right. Okay. This isn't Hawk Moth. This is like wax Hawk Moth. But how do they know what a Hawk Moth looks like?
Good question. How do they know what Hawk Moth looks like?
Puppeteer episode.
No, but
he was also there at the end of season two when they were all having that big battle.
Yeah, that's true. I guess they took some snaps of him.
But they're supposed... Waxworks are supposed to be super detailed. So how is he like a direct copy of exactly what
Hawk
Moth
looks
like?
Why would you want that as
do you
well?
Reckon like... someone in the waxwork department was like, can't really work with these zoomed in photos. Hey, you know what, guys? He looks a little bit like Adrien Agreste's dad. Like, we've got him on file. Let's just make him look like that. Nice.
Yeah.
Marinette, go get some help.
Oh no, you're going to stay and play with me this time.
Manon? I know we've said this before. Where is security?
Well, it's closed today. Like, this is like a VIP tour.
They should
no one else
have, like, some CCTV being watched or something, though.
you'd think there would be CCTV. And also, guards should be there even when it's closed. Yeah. So, you know, that's why the whole Night at the Museum trilogy exists, because the night shift at a museum is a thing.
The night guard.
Nope, I am the puppeteer, and I want to play with you and my statue.
I know this is not real Hawk Moth, but I really, really love Hawk Moth versus Adrien / Cat Noir, because I'm like,
oh my god, it's so good.
It's almost like it's a bit of father-son anti-bonding.
It's the closest he's ever been to his dad. And that's a wax figure.
Sad.
I'll handle this.
Black claws out!
Who's already ready? Who are your favorite?
Sorry. That's a lot. Oh, don't those lifts have CCTV?
Probably. But it's fine, because Madame Tussauds knows.
Think about the amount of times that they've transformed in like public places / museums / places that absolutely...
But they're always vaguely behind something, Miranda. I don't know, understand what you're saying.
Yeah, apologies. Sorry. I must respect the bench.
Like that bench in the park. Like, it's pretty cool.
You go behind it and you're invisible. Very powerful T pose there.
Thanks.
For tier two.
I don't like it.
The really important things are the hardest to say, aren't they?
It's precisely when something is important that it's important to say it, no matter what.
Thank you. Thank you. There's some sense from this boy.
Yeah, interesting that.
Would you mind?
Oh, I know.
Bring me the head of Thomas Astruc.
Oh, Lord, he coming.
I really like that shot, but like where he like tilts, kicked her over, but the camera like tilted.
That was very good.
That was very cool.
Oh, I do love an evil Cat Noir moment.
It deserves a little scratch under the chin before going up, right?
The little jazzy music kicks off.
Jazzy like elevator music is like.
Is that a new perfume, m'lady? This one smells like wax.
Adrien / Cat Noir is able to work out that this is a waxwork, but Marinette was not able to work out that Adrien was a real person.
Unbelievable.
Who was literally breathing. Unless Adrien's really good at holding his breath. That's well creepy. I really don't like the wax hands.
Hands off, you pale imitation. Only one cat is allowed to have her hand.
Thanks, Kitty.
Have you found out what to do with your lucky charm?
I really like it when she calls him Kitty.
I know, it's really cute.
Who's puppeteer? I don't care. If you break my wand, I'll just turn them into real wax statues. No, don't do that. Fine.
Classic waxwork episode.
This is a classic staple of a waxwork museum episode. Somebody is held over the vat of wax. And they're like, I'll turn them into real waxworks. And it's like, okay, that's not how that works.
Yeah.
Real weapon. Too late. No more evil doing.
Pranked. There's an awful lot of like role play and like acting and pranking going on.
That was a very good tactical move. I'm into that.
Yeah.
There we are, all back together again.
Hey, wait! Manon has to see this. Oh, but where is she?
They literally do have a Gabriel aggressed waxwork on file. So all I'm saying is they just reskinned that one for Hawk Moth.
God.
This is just so tragic, isn't
it? Hey, maybe if you just talk to each other.
The girl I'm in love with doesn't like them either.
The girl.
Oh dear. I mean, it is you, Marinette. It's just...
She doesn't know.
I can pinpoint the moment her heart breaks in two.
See you tomorrow at school?
Yeah.
Just shot the car door in his face.
Right, okay, everyone goes off on Cat Noir for like being a bit of a like the friend zone thing. I'm sorry, she just immediately ignored any like prospect of being his friend now. She's like, yeah, bye.
I don't think she like has made that decision. I think she's just like feeling a bit in shock.
No,
Bye.
No, it sometimes is. It does throw you for a loop. You know, if somebody you really like,
you thought you just had a chance,
casually drops in conversation. They're like, oh yeah, this person that I love, and you're like, oh okay then, I see how dear. It is. Yeah, so I get that she's upset, but also, like, don't take it out on Adrien. It's not his fault that you completely mucked up every single interaction you had with him today.
That was all you, babe.
You heard him. Adrien's in love with another girl, and me? I'm just a friend.
Oh, I'm sure life has many surprises in store for you, Marinette.
Why does she just seem a friend? So small?
Tiki knows who Adrien is, can we just point out? Like, Tiki is well aware that Adrien is Cat Noir. And this isn't like a theory. This was like there's in Dark Owl.
She knows.
Tiki.
She knows.
Tiki and Flag know who they are. And Tiki's just there like, oh well.
It's good.
Offers vague advice. It'll be fine.
It'll be fine. Well, I also think that Tiki isn't allowed to tell her.
She can't tell her. She's like physically incapable of doing it. However, she could probably be a bit more.
She could be like, listen, I can't say anything.
But I'm just saying.
But I know some things, and you don't got to worry about it.
You don't need to worry about it.
You know?
Yeah, that would have been one very silly first kiss, anyways.
You don't say.
They're not very good at this whole being friends thing,
are
they?
No.
It's all like, they're told that they're in the friend zone. And they're like, yeah, but, you know.
Unless.
I hate that.
what if we were more than friends?
God,
I'm just kidding.
I hate that.
Unless.
What if we kiss in the Waxwork Museum? Haha, just kidding.
Unless.
We are done watching The Puppeteer 2.
I'm stressed.
That was a lot.
It was quite a stressful episode.
I'm tired. I need a nap.
I do quite like the scene at the end where they're in the car and they do talk about their feelings a little bit.
It's cute to see them actually like have a conversation.
Yeah. Because I think that scene in the Waxwork Museum is a bit cringe, but it's like, after it just get resolved a little bit.
It's just very hard to watch because you can totally see how this has ended up happening, but it doesn't make it any less.
They're just so in love.
Yeah, well, listen, this will be a great story they can laugh about at their wedding.
Yeah.
This is exactly the kind of story that should be told at the wedding.
Yeah, which will obviously happen.
Other strong opinions I have, Manon is still the worst.
She is bad.
Yeah, I'm not.
She didn't learn her lesson for the first time.
But I hope you guys enjoyed our reaction to it. Thank you for requesting it.
We had a blast watching it.
We did have a blast.
We did, yeah.
You guys always have things to add, so if you want to add anything, pop it in the comments below.
Yes, yeah, we love reading your comments. As some of you who comment on the regular know, I am usually the person responding, so let me know. But if you want to speak to these two, then do leave a question specifically for them, and I'll send it on and we'll get a response.
What did you guys think of that classic waxwork scene?
Like, did you think it was cute or bit difficult to watch? If you disagree with us, let us know, because I would love to know what you all think. Also, if you're enjoying the fact that we've put Luminara in the middle of the table, leave a thumbs up. Let us know if there's any particular episodes that you want us to react to. Leave a comment down below.
Make sure you're subscribed and press the bell button if you want to get notified on our future episodes.
And thank you for watching with us, and see you next time.
Bye.
Chili's.